Like they say, live every day like it's your last, right? That don't mean go out there like a damn jackass. Yeah, that simply means take risks. Yeah, that's what that means to me. Take risks. Yeah, because if you know something, if it was your last day, yeah, you would take a risk. Yeah, live every day like it's your last does not mean, okay, I'm just gonna spend all my money on this holiday, that holiday, this car, this clothes. No, it don't mean that. Does not mean that. There's people who live like that, That's their philosophy. Live every day like it's their last. And those are the people who end up living to 80 years old, broke as a joke. Yeah, they enjoy themselves, but you don't want to be like, there's people out here, pensioners, they're struggling in the winter. You don't want to be a pensioner in the winter, struggling to heat your house. Struggling to pay £3 a day to heat your yard in the winter, or £5 a day to heat your house in the winter. You do not want to be those pensioners, I'm telling you. And I don't feel no remorse for these pensioners who are in a position like that, because hear that fucking dog next door. I don't feel no remorse for these pensioners who are in that position. Yeah, these people who are 65, 70 years old. What was you doing over the last 30 years? 30 years. This man who could have fucking become millionaires three, four times and lost it and got it back in that time in 30 years. What have you done in that last 30 years? Was you grinding hard? Or was you living a mediocre life? Was you settling for mediocrity? Yeah. Was you working in Asda? Was you working in Sainsbury's? Yeah. Was you working for that big man over there as a PA? Yeah, just collecting your little idiot wage at the end of every month and spending it. So me, like you people will say, yeah, it's harsh and I don't feel no remorse for any pensioners who are struggling. Yeah. So long as like if they had good health, normal health, physical health, mental health, yeah, throughout the entirety of their life, I don't feel sorry for none of them. Now, obviously, if they had something wrong with them, then yeah, that's cool, whatever, innit? Yeah. But there's nothing wrong with you. Yeah, if you've got good physical mental health, there's no excuse not to be successful. Yeah. Don't blame the government. Yeah. Don't blame anything on the color of your skin. Yeah. Don't blame that you're from a poor background. Yeah. It's all bullshit, fam. I'm from a poor background. I'm black. Yeah. I'm from a bad area. I've even been to prison. I've been in trouble. I was in a gang. I've been stabbed. And I've made something of myself. So if I've done it, yeah, everyone else can. I guarantee you. Yeah. Don't let the government, don't let people, parents out here tell them from day one, because you're black, you're gonna have to work twice as hard after a result. Bullshit. It's garbage. Yeah. But people make sense of that because they go for a job interview and sorry, they go for a promotion at work. And oh, my white counterpart, yeah, my white colleague gets the position over me. Hold on a minute, he might have been better for the job. He might have had more leadership qualities than you. He might have been more on the point, on point with his paperwork. Yeah. It's all well and good, going for a job position, but are you really right for that job position? Yeah. Are you really right for that promotion? Yeah. Man complaining about working in TGI Fridays for 6 years, not getting a promotion. Blood, you're missing the point, fam. Why are you working in TGI Fridays for 6 years? Yeah, that's a 6 month job. Yeah, I need this job to get on my feet, pay one, two bills, bam, I'm out, get a better job.